Amy Gordon is my sixth novel, and sometimes I wonder why I'm writing books for teenagers when I'm actually 58 years old. And the only way I can answer that question is that I'm writing books for how I look at being young and look at it from the distance of being much older. So this book was very much about a father and a daughter who are about to go to America to visit his best friend, who he hasn't seen in quite a long time. And suddenly they discover, just before they make the trip, that he's disappeared. And so what happens is the father and the daughter, who's 12 years old, go off on this trip anyway. And it's really, ostensibly, it's in order to find the friend. Why has he disappeared? To find out why. When I wrote the book, I didn't know why he disappeared. And it was a real problem for me because I was quite frightened that I would get to the very end of the book and I would still not know why he disappeared. And that's kind of what happened. I wrote draft after draft after draft after draft, and I still didn't know why he left. But what I discovered and what I was hoping for was that the book would start to tell me, that the book would reveal to me the reasons that a person might run away. And in the course of writing the book, I discovered that really what it was about was not so much the man who disappeared, but it was about the relationship between the father and the daughter. And I've noticed in books for teenagers that mainly they despise their parents, that there's a terrible relationship, and it's kind of a caricature, I think, of how teenagers relate to their parents. But I actually have a teenage daughter who's an only child, and in fact, the three of us, my husband and my daughter and I, get along very well. But one of the things I was thinking about was what happens when even the best of intentions between parents and children goes slightly wrong, where parents are trying very much to tell the truth to a child, but somehow it starts to twist and they get it wrong. And this child in this book is incredibly prescient. She's a little bit like Sherlock in the TV series. And I loved that. I loved the idea that a person could walk into a room and see more than an average person could see. And that's what she does. She can look and she can see what's missing, what's wrong with a photograph, what's wrong with the clothes on the floor. And so in a way, although she's only 12, she has a kind of wisdom that the adults around her have lost. And because I never really know how my books are going to turn out, for me it was a great exploration of those kind of issues. Where are children wiser than parents? How do parents try to be good parents and fail? And in the meantime, I managed to write a mystery book. A kind of a whodunit, which I didn't really mean to write at all. So you never know what you're going to end up with.